In this video, we're going to create an application that works for different language settings and also for different screen orientations and resolutions. And I've gone ahead and started up Android Studio. Before I start, I want to show you about one setting. If you go to the settings, you'll notice that under compiler, there are a couple of options that will be unchecked. So compile independent modules in parallel, make project automatically. If you go ahead and check these for your project, that will make your compile go faster. And if you want to set these as the defaults for all the projects you create, you can go to Project Defaults, Settings, and then check these two boxes here. So that should speed up your compile a little bit. Now I'm going to go ahead and create a new Android Studio project, and I'm going to call it Meals. For API level 10 and above. And I'll start with the usual blank activity with the action bar. And I'll leave this as main activity. Okay, so this is ready to go. Before I start, let me show you what I'm going to do. So I've done a little drawing. And what I'm going to have is in portrait, there's going to be a row of buttons along the top that are sort of equally spaced to fill the width. And then there's going to be a picture underneath that, so an image view. And then in landscape, there's going to be a button bar on the left side with the buttons stacked, and then the same image view. So the way I'm going to get this layout is to have a linear layout in the outside with horizontal items. And then the first item in the linear layout is going to be a linear layout. I'm sorry, the outer one has vertically stacked items. The inner one is going to be a linear layout with horizontally stacked items, and then buttons inside. And then for the landscape version, there's going to be a horizontal linear layout on the outside, and then this inside linear layout will be vertical orientation. So, let's go ahead and start there, and I'm going to go to the text view and change the outside layout to linear layout, and I'm going to do that for both the start and end tag, and I'm going to add an orientation in here. So this one's going to be vertical, and then inside I'm going to have another linear layout, and we're going to fill parent. My buttons will go in here. So the orientation on this one is going to be horizontal. So I'm going to have three buttons, and these are all going to be, I'm going to change these, but we'll just put fill parent for now. So what I want to have for my three buttons is each button should take roughly the same width. And so for the layout width, I'm going to specify 0 dp, but then I'm going to add a weight, which is just going to be 1. And then if I have three buttons, they're each going to get 1/3 of the total width. So let's go ahead and add some text to these buttons. So the first text is going to be a resource called chicken. And I'm going to go to my values strings and create a string resource named chicken with the text chicken. Now I'm going to do the same thing for the other two buttons. This is going to be beef, and this is going to be fish. And I'm going to add two more string resources, beef and fish. And then I'm going to have my image view underneath there. And this is going to be fill parent as well to use the rest of the available space. So let me go ahead and add IDs to all of these. So this is going to be my display image. And then this is going to be a chicken button. And this is going to be beef button. And this is going to be the fish button. Now, in the past, I haven't put IDs on buttons, but here, the reason I'm going to do that is because any button that you click, it's all going to call the same method in the activity, an onClick handler for the activity. And then I'm going to use the ID of the button to figure out which button was pressed. So this way I don't have to have separate methods for each button. So let me add an onClick, and this is going to call setMeal. And I'm going to add the same method for the onClick for each button. So let's go ahead and go to our Java code. And I'm going to add my setMeal method. Public void setMeal, and it's going to get the button that I clicked on. And Alt plus Enter to resolve that. And I'm not going to do it yet, so let me just see whether my layout looks correct or not. Okay, so these are all stretched because my image view isn't taking up any space. So let's go ahead and put a source image in there. Go ahead and rotate this the right way around. So you see that the buttons are filling the available space, but there's no, the image view isn't taking up any space. So let's go ahead and put an image in the image view. And I'm going to put an American flag here. And let's go ahead and grab this one because it's the right orientation. So I'm going to save this image as, and I'm already in Android projects, meals, app, source, main, resources, drawable. And I'm going to call this flag.png. And then I'm going to go to my layout and I'm going to add a source to my image view, which is going to be a drawable called flag. Okay, so now I have a flag in my image view, which should expand to fill as much space as possible. Okay, and then I also have to set the height of this layout to just be wrap content, so it's only as tall as the buttons are. Oops. There we go. Okay, so now I have the buttons along the top and they filled the width, they're equally spaced. And I have my image view underneath there. So let's go ahead and do button handlers. And I'm going to go back to the Java code. And when the user clicks on any button, the button's going to be passed in. So I want to get the ID of the button and then compare it to the IDs that I added in my layout. So we're going to have an int button ID is equal to button.getID, and then an if statement, if button ID is equal r.id dot chicken button, then I do something for the chicken, else if button ID is equal to the beef button, then I do something for beef, else if button ID is the fish button, then I do something for fish. Okay, so what am I going to do if they click on the chicken button? Well, I'm going to get a picture of a delicious chicken meal. And what I actually want is this delicious chicken meal. Yummy. Okay, so I'm gonna save this image as, and my drawable called this chicken gif. And now let's get a delicious American beef meal. Yummy. And we'll save this as beef.jpg. And finally, let's get a delicious American fish meal. Look at the mayonnaise. That one's Australian. Let's get this one. Okay, so now we have three yummy American meals. And then if they click on the chicken button, I'm going to start by getting the image view. So the display image. Yeah, display image. Alt plus enter to import. And here I'm going to set meal.setImageResource to r.drawable.chicken. And here we'll set it to beef. And here we'll set it to fish. Okay, so let's test it. Okay, all these images will take a little while. So, chicken, beef, fish. Yummy. Okay, so this is working. Now let's go ahead and do our landscape layout. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right-click on the resources folder and create a new Android resource file. And it's going to have the same name as my other layout, which is activityMain.xml. And it's going to be a layout resource. And then the way I'm going to make this work for landscape is I'm going to go to available qualifiers and select orientation and add it. And then select the drop-down for landscape. I can do landscape or square. And what this actually did, if I go to the project layout, is now you'll see that there's a layout folder with my first activity main, and also layout-land with my landscape activity main. So the way this works is, if I'm in landscape, it will go to layout land first. If there is one, it will use that. Otherwise, it defaults to the one that's in layout. If I'm in portrait, it will go for layout-portrait first, but there isn't one. So I get this one for portrait, this one for landscape, and if I had square, then I would get this one as well. So let's go ahead and modify this layout. And I'm going to start by copying my previous layout, and then I'm going to tweak it for the landscape. So in landscape, I want to have a horizontal outer layout with a vertical inner layout. So we'll make this horizontal, and we'll make this vertical. And then the button bar should wrap content for the width and fill content, fill parent for the height. And then each of these buttons should fill parent for the layout width. But then the layout height should just be wrap content. Okay, so let's go ahead and try that. Okay, so there's my portrait, and now I'm going to rotate the screen. Good. So not quite. I want each button to only wrap, and then this whole layout should be just big enough to contain the buttons. So let me go ahead and do that. So this one, the layout height should be wrap content. And now if I try it, okay, good, that's what I wanted. So I'm going to hit this beef button to wait for it to compute everything. Great. So now I have this layout in landscape, and I have that layout in portrait.